डॉक्टर गंजू वी आर लाइव।
A big hello and good evening to all the participants, parents, teachers, students, and all those who are watching us live today. I welcome you all to the first live webinar series on enhancing immunity to live with positivity, organized by DAV Public School Sector 49. I am Dr. Meenakshi, your coordinator for this session. We all know that we are going through so much of negativity and scare associated with coronavirus nowadays. Adding to the fact that there is no vaccine for prevention, no treatment for cure as of now. So it becomes all the more imperative that we understand the concept of immunity and positivity. So in this session, our panelists are going to help us doing just the same. Not wasting much of your time, let me introduce you to the moderator of the session. She is none other than Mrs. Charu Maini, the principal of DAV Public School. She needs no introduction. She is a true visionary, academician, and administrator for 25 years. Her work is a testimony of her dedication and enthusiasm. Apart from teaching, she is actively associated with CBSE, NCERT, and various other portals. We welcome you, ma'am. Thank you so much for joining.
So much, Dr. Meenakshi.
Herein, I want to add on something specific is that she has a very, very keen interest on the holistic development of children. And that's the reason we are here today. So that's the reason. So we have our eminent, let me introduce you to our eminent panelists also. We have Dr. Vikas Deswal, who is a consultant in infectious diseases at Medanta Medicity, Sector 38, Gurgaon. He is actively involved in care of patients with complex infectious diseases and research. His areas of expertise includes viral infections, TB, HIV, and bacterial infections. We welcome you, Dr. Vikas Deswal. The reason you are here today is because of your expertise in viral infections, and coronavirus is the cause. Thank you so much for joining us. Next, we have Dr. Bibin. Welcome. Next, we have Dr. Bibin VK, is a consultant physician Ayurveda in Medanta Medicity. He is an expert in holistic treatment, which includes diet regulation and lifestyle modification. He is specialized in Keralia Panchakarma therapies and Ayurveda parasurgical procedures. Dr. Bibin, we welcome you. The reason, again, I would say the reason you are here today is Ayurveda is the one of the most important things needed during COVID times. Hot water, all other decoctions, we always talk about Ayurveda being a part. Thank you for joining us tonight.
Thank you, Doctor.
Welcome. Our next eminent panelist is yet and again, Mr. Deepak Kumar Jha, is a leading yoga and lifestyle expert with over 12 years of experience. He features in magazines, newspapers, and TV channels very frequently. He has some esteemed clients to his credit, like Mr. Sunil Bharti Mittal, Mr. Kamal Nath, and many other politicians and actors. Mr. Deepak Kumar, we welcome you on this program. Without you, again, lifestyle is incomplete without yoga. We all know that. We welcome you. And we have another panelist with us, Dr. Kajal, who is yet to join us. Probably she'll be joining. Has she joined? Has Dr. Kajal joined? No. Okay. We have another panelist. Let me tell you all. We have another panelist, Dr. Kajal. She's the head of Department of Nutrition and Dietetics at Medanta Medicity. She has vast experience of more than 22 years. A lot of research work to her credit. And we all know with no immunity is possible without nutrition and all. So she had to be here today. Oh, Dr. Kajal is live with us. We welcome you. I was just speaking to you, speaking about you only. So we welcome you here. And I was just telling no immunity is possible without nutrition. Immunity boosting cannot be possible without nutrition.
Yeah, it goes hand in hand.
It goes hand in hand. In fact, all the eminent panelists which we have here, it would not have been possible because in these times, lifestyle is included. It includes all these important components. So thank you so much. Not wasting much of the time, I would like to ma'am Charu Maini, ma'am, to take over the moderator.
Thank you so much, Dr. Meenakshi, for the wonderful introduction of all the panelists, and a very, very warm welcome to all our dear parents, teachers, students, and all others who have joined us on the watch party at the Facebook Live. And to tell you the truth, this is for the first time that we are going live like this on the Facebook and having a panel discussion. So it's a kind of examination for us. And this COVID-19 has brought so many new things to our lives, so many things that we had not even imagined, not even thought of. Who had thought that the teachers would be teaching digitally, sitting at home and giving instructions? And I'm so proud of the team that we have at school, besides the COVID warriors in the hospitals and on the roads in the form of the police. The teachers' role can also not be, we cannot say that they have not done anything, because they have learned so fast. On 19th of March, this lockdown, the first lockdown was announced, and from 23rd March, the teachers had started working on it. So welcome you all. I believe this is a singular moment for the world and unprecedented time. Jaisa na humne kabhi suna tha, na kabhi dekha tha. I will not say that these are difficult times, because pareshani unhi ko pareshan karte jo pareshan hote hain, isn't it? These times are different. Okay, the times are different, and yes, they are challenging. So the tough, when the going gets tough, the tough get going. So we all here at DAV, with the help of the team Medanta, we have Dr. Vikas, Dr. Vipin, Dr. Kajal, and Mr. Deepak. Thank you so much for joining us here. And we will start with this Living Positively, the first series of the webinar, so that we all are strong and here to charge on. So I'll start with you, Dr. Deswal, Dr. Vikas. Speaking from the infectious diseases, first of all, just for a layman, what is this COVID-19? Why this name, COVID-19? What is it?
So we all have been living with these coronavirus diseases for years. We know they exist for many, many years. We have had epidemics of coronaviruses infection in the past also, like the 2003 outbreak of SARS, and then 2009 and 2013 outbreak of MERS. So it is a coronavirus is a group of virus which has many subspecies in it. And this time the virus which originated in Wuhan in December 2019 is a novel strain of those already existing coronaviruses. So that's why it is called, was initially called as novel coronavirus. Later on in February 2020, WHO came up with this term called as COVID-19, which means that coronavirus infectious disease caused by a novel strain of 2019. So the COVID-19 is a disease which is caused by coronavirus. And subsequently, since this was a novel strain of the already existing coronaviruses in our world, so that's why they renamed the coronavirus which caused this, which was responsible for this outbreak which originated in 2019 as SARS-CoV-2. So SARS-CoV-2 is a virus from the coronavirus family which causes COVID-19, which is a disease.
Okay.
So SARS-CoV-2 is the name of the virus. COVID-19 is the name of the disease.
Fine. And why so much of stress on washing hands and taking bath? And I would also like to know that how every time that I go out of my home, like I stay in an apartment called condominium. So if I'm just going down to buy some vegetables and I come back, do I have to change my clothes and wash myself up? Pura, matlab, just washing hands will do? Or do I have to take bath every time that I go out? So one, I want to know why so much of stress on washing ourselves up with soap, and how much of washing is required? That is also we wish to know.
So these all these coronaviruses and other respiratory viruses spread by droplet infection. Most of them spread by droplet infection. In addition to that, these coronaviruses also spread by contact infections. So if somebody, you have gone out and somebody is sneezing or coughing, that he in that he is sneezing out virus particles, and those virus particles can travel up to 3 to 4 meter distance. 3 to 4 feet distance, up to 1 meter. That's why so much of importance on social distancing of 2 meter or 6 feet apart. That is the reason for that. It does not travel beyond 3 feet. It has got a good amount of weight according to the microbiologist, and it just falls down after 3 feet. So that is why so much of stress on maintaining social distancing of up to 2 meters. Second thing is that suppose somebody has coughed out or sneezed out viral particles and they have fallen on skin surface. If you touch those surfaces, and your hands would be contaminated with those viruses. And if those hands touch your face, eyes, nose, or any part of the body above the neck, then you can get the infection. So that is why so much of emphasis on maintaining social distancing and hand washing. That is probably the most important steps to prevent coronavirus disease. Now, how frequently to wash? And I would say as much as you can. Whenever you go out, you come to the home, first thing you should do is wash your hands with soap and water, or clean your hands with alcohol-based hand rubs.
Okay, and changing of clothes and taking a bath, it's not necessary.
That is little overboard. You actually do not need to change your clothes or take bath every time you come come back home, whenever you're going to the market or going to the workplace. That you don't need. But washing your hands is the most important step.
Dr. Deshpan,
okay,
I want to add on a little more onto that. We stress, I think there are some misconceptions among people also, where I want you to add stress on that. Because every time people go out, they have this that once we are back, we immediately go to the washroom, change clothes, put them for dry or put them for washing, and head to toe bath, in fact. So that you could clear a little more.
So there is enough literature now that it does not spread through. Like suppose it has fallen on your hair, okay. Suppose it has fallen on your shoes, okay. Suppose it has fallen on your clothes. It does not spread that way. It has to come to your hands, go to your face. That's the only way you can get it. Or somebody has coughed up or sneezed on your face. That's the other way. There is no literature according to the scientific evidence that you need to take bath every time you come back home.
Okay.
When I go back to home from hospital, even I do not take it. I just remove my clothes and that's it. Wash my hands, enough. That's enough.
Okay.
And yesterday only I was reading an article from head of Department of Infectious Disease of Mayo Clinic in US. He specifically was talking about shoes and washing legs and all those things. He also said that there is no benefit of that, and that is a little overboard, according to him also.
Okay. Dr. Vikas, like I said, I stay in a condominium, and if I'm staying in Tower X and someone in Tower Y on the 10th floor has tested positive, coronavirus positive, then how much care should I have, and what kind of precautions do I have to take? Though the society says, okay, this floor is now sealed, nothing else. What is your take on this?
So the risk exposure is defined by the duration of your exposure to that person, the closeness to that person, and the third thing is whether you are wearing a mask or not. So if you are wearing a mask and the person X who is infected is also wearing a mask, and your contact was less than 15 minutes with that person, that in that category, you fall into a low risk category. The chance of you acquiring an infection from that person, if both of them are wearing a mask and your contact with that person was less than 15 minutes, the chance of you getting a COVID infection from that person is very low, extremely low. So if you haven't met that person at all, the chances of that you acquiring an infection from him is almost negligible. So the risk exposure risk is defined by three things. if both are wearing a mask, whether both the persons are wearing a mask, the person who's infected and the person who's getting exposed. Second thing is the duration of the exposure. The duration of the exposure should be more than 15 for it to qualify as a high risk exposure. And third thing is the distance, how close you were when the exposure happened. If the exposure is within 6 feet, it qualifies as a high risk exposure. Anything away, anything more than 6 feet is a low risk exposure.
Another thing, Dr. Vikas, I would like to know, jo bahut zyada sunne mein aa raha hai, symptomatic patient hai, asymptomatic patient hai, aaj maine ek aur nayi cheez suni, pre-symptomatic patient hai, people hai, to kaise ye sab pata chalega ki whether I am symptomatic or asymptomatic or a pre-symptomatic person? So how do you
look? Symptomatic is the are the ones who develop symptoms like fever, cough, sore throat, diarrhea, anosmia, like anosmia means loss of smell or loss of taste. Those would be myalgias, headache, those would be the main symptoms. That if anyone who has symptoms, he qualifies, he's like a symptomatic patient and he should be tested on priority and should get isolated. Then there is something called as asymptomatic patient. There are many patients who get this infection who have good immunity and they are able to clear this virus without even developing symptoms. So those are called as asymptomatic patients. They can also spread this infection to others, despite they not having symptoms. So that is one of the major concern area in the epidemiology of COVID-19. So we may not be knowing who is infected, who is not. That is why so much emphasis on maintaining social distancing. Third thing is the pre-symptomatic. Pre-symptomatic is the one who has just come in contact with a person who has a COVID infection, has acquired the infection, but has not developed any symptoms, but 2 or 3 days later will go on and develop symptoms. So anyone with symptoms becomes infective from -2 days.
Before.
-2 days. Suppose person X has developed symptoms on 4th of June. That means that he was infective to other persons from 2nd of June onwards.
Mm-hmm.
And the maximum infectivity is from day 1 to day 2 or 3. After that, the infectivity starts to decline down.
Okay.
And it is very less in the second week of infection.
So if someone is having symptoms of fever, etc., and also tested positive, so let's say 5 days have passed, the probability of that person spreading the disease is less. Is that what you mean?
Probability of transmitting the disease becomes almost negligible after day 8 or 9.
Okay.
He's infected from -2 to day 8, 9, 10.
Fine. Another thing, Dr. Vikas, because the symptoms of COVID are so general, fever, yeah, cough, sneezing, diarrhea, जो कि इन दिनों गर्मियों के दिनों में वैसे भी धूप से आए तो हल्का फीवर 99 से 100.2 तक तो वैसे भी कई बार हो जाता है, तो ऐसे में कब मुझे भागना होगा फॉर गेटिंग अ कोविड टेस्ट इफ आई एम हैविंग अ लाइक से 99 और 100.2 काइंड ऑफ अ फीवर, थोड़ी देर के लिए आता है एंड वो क्रोसिन से मतलब चला भी जाता है पैरासिटामोल से, तो हाउ डू आई know whether the test.
We are currently in the middle of a pandemic and Gurgaon sort of has become a hot zone. Anyone who has fever or any of the respiratory symptoms, as I explained, like cough, sore throat, running nose, breathing difficulty, or a GI symptoms like diarrhea and loss of smell and loss of taste, he should seek medical help and should get tested on priority. Because the only way we can control the infection is to diagnose people and isolate them. If suppose that person, we are not testing that person, then he is saying that it's just like a viral infection. He would keep meeting people and he would keep spreading it to others. So the very important aspect in the management controlling overall control of this infection is rapid identification of the system, early testing, early diagnosis, and then isolating. So very important, anyone with these symptoms currently in Gurgaon should go and get tested.
And even if my pulse oximeter shows a good oxygen content as 95 or 97, to bhi jana hoga mujhe checking ke liye?
Yes, ma'am. If you have those symptoms which I described earlier, you should go and get tested. This just tells you that you have mild, moderate, or severe disease. This pulse oximeter thing does not tell you that you have disease or not. It tells you that if you have COVID, then if your oxygen is more than 94, 95, you have mild disease. If it is between 90 to 94, you have moderate disease. If it is less than 90, you have severe disease. That is what it tells. It does not tell you that whether you have it or not, you do not have.
Dr. Vikas, there is a misconception among people, which I want you to clear to all our audience also, that people think that if it is an asymptomatic disease, like wherein there is mild fever and maybe mild cough, if we stay isolated from the rest of the family members inside the room, it will not spread. Within 4 or 5 days, it will be okay. So those people also, you think we should get them examined and ask them to get themselves tested?
Yes, ma'am. They should also get themselves tested. Even those with mild symptoms should get themselves tested, because that is the only way we can detect them, we can have actual number, and we can isolate them. Because if they feel that they
because
have
what people are thinking, what people are thinking nowadays is like the isolation, what the doctors are recommending is home isolation. So why not stay at home only and stay within inside and not connect with anybody? And what is the need of roller? So we have to emphasize that even if you have mild infection, it is very, very important to get yourself tested. So herein, yes, to all the audience, we have to emphasize, even if somebody has very mild infection, that means it could be asymptomatic fever, cough, or anything, please get yourself tested. This is what our doctor Vikas, an expert least, on infectious diseases.
Or at least seek medical
advice. डर के घर में नहीं बैठना है, क्योंकि कोरोना का डर ज्यादा पड़ गया है कि वो पीपी सूट्स में लोग आएंगे और पकड़ के ले जाएंगे और लेटा देंगे. So I think
it is not like that way, man. Now it was like that 2 months back. It is not like that now. Now the government has issued home care guidelines, home quarantine guidelines. If you are tested positive, if you have mild disease and no warning signs, you can stay at home and you can continue the isolation at home itself. You can do video consultation.
That is the reason I wanted you to emphasize on people, on our audience, saying that even if it is asymptomatic, please get yourself tested. Because shortly we'll have rainy season also coming in. All other viral fevers will also pour in. So a lot of confusion will arise maybe in a month or so. So it's very important to get yourself tested here.
Last thing that I would like to ask is about what are the centers from which reliable centers for my audience from which I can get the testing done.
So there are a lot of laboratories which are functioning in Gurgaon. Medanta is one of the biggest center which has handled COVID in the past, and we have a testing laboratory which tests around 150 to 250 samples in a day. So patients can come to Medanta. We have a dedicated separate area where they would be taken to. There is a flu clinic. They would be examined by a doctor over there. And if needed, they would be prescribed to get tested then and there itself. And the test would be done within 10-15 minutes in that flu clinic itself. So that flu clinic is a separate area. Why we have separated is because we do not want it to mix with our other patients, because there is a very high risk of cross-infection. So it is a completely separate dedicated area where only those patients who have suspect or those who want to come and get tested will come, would be seen by a doctor, a prescription would be generated, and they would be tested then and there itself. other than Medanta, there are many other laboratories where you can go and get yourself tested. But as per ICMR guidelines, you need a prescription from a doctor before you go to any laboratory to get yourself tested. So first seek medical help. The doctor would make a prescription for you. Then it is up to you. You can go to any lab in Gurgaon to get yourself tested. The other laboratories other than Medanta, which are doing, are Artemis, Fortis, SRL laboratory, Lal pathology laboratory, then PathKind, these Strand lab. These are the few other labs which also do this test, and the Modern Diagnostic Center.
Sir, actually, our Facebook page, which is live, there are so many people and who wish to ask some questions. So there is Ma'am Jyoti Sharma who wishes to ask again, is it necessary that I have to go to the lab to get myself tested, or someone can come to my home and test?
Ma'am, the answer to that is, first, we need a prescription. You have to seek medical help. A qualified medical practitioner will make a prescription. Today only ICMR has issued concern about teleconsultations also. So ICMR is becoming very, very strict on it. And because Gurgaon, there are lots and lots of cases. There's going to be a deep, deep investigation in Gurgaon. So nobody wants to get in trouble now. So my suggestion is go the right way, seek medical help, get a prescription, and then go to any lab, or if the lab is willing to come to your home to collect your sample, then it's fine. But you should have a prescription. That is the most important thing. Few of the labs like SRL and 1MG, the labs which are tied up with 1MG, are collecting it from the home.
I think we should shift to Dr. Kajal now, but there are questions.
There are a lot of questions. Dr. Vikas, last question. There's another question. How long will it, does it take for the reports of the tests to come?
Again, it depends on the lab where you are getting it tested.
Okay.
If you go to the civil hospital and get tested in a civil hospital, the turnaround time for the test is 2 days, 24 to 48 hours.
Okay.
If you go to any of the private labs, the turnaround time is 24 to 36 hours. In Medanta, if it depends on the severity of your category of illness. If the pain is very severe, where it falls into a very sick category, the report would be available in 6 to 8 hours on a working day, provided you have given the sample before 1 p.m. Any sample after 1 p.m., the report would be available by next day, 1 p.m.
Okay.
But majority of the labs, the turnaround time is 24 hours.
There are questions on masks.
We'll take a detailed version of mask. I think we can go ahead, ma'am, with Dr. Kajal.
Now we should shift to Dr. Kajal. Hello, Dr. Kajal. Thank you so much for joining in, rushing in for our webinar and sparing your time. So without wasting much time, because it's just rushing and the questions are also pouring, especially for you.
Pouring in.
Please tell me.
So sabse pehla to yehi pooch rahe hain. Suggest some food items that will help in boosting of immunity, and which my child can eat, and whether a regular dose of vitamins if I give to my child, whether that would help in fighting the COVID-19, and we will.
Okay, so let me start off by saying that immunity cannot be developed overnight. That anybody would say, right? So if we start developing good habits of eating, that is the best, and this is the best time to start with this, you know, kind of. So I would say no one particular food is going to improve out the immunity. It has to be the group of food groups which we eat in our day-to-day life that is more important, and that is what is going to help us to improve our immunity. Now, in that, you can ask me which all foods which we can eat, so we can go food-wise or group-wise. But I would say that what healthy food we were not eating earlier, before the COVID, I think that it would be this would be the best time for us to start eating those healthy foods which you already knew of. This is what I would say, you know, kind of. So if you were taking a lot of junk food, so anyways, it is not available. So might as well try to start cooking food at home, so children can have a taste of home food. same food which we were ordering can be made at home with the mother's touch. So that is one thing which can be done. Secondly, include fruits and vegetables, which our children actually don't take too much. So this would be the best time to inculcate that habits for them. And you can keep it in the house and everybody is going to eat. So I'm sure...
What are the scent vegetables?
Hello?
Hello?
I didn't get the question. Hello?
You please continue. You please continue.
Okay.
So there is another question which we have received. What is the role of vitamin D in immunity, especially when the children are inside, they're not going out? What is the role of vitamin D in immunity? That's another question.
Yeah, vitamin D definitely helps in the immunity, not only in the immunity, it helps in many other factors, you know, kind of. And our children were exposed, were, if you really tell me, our children were actually not exposed to enough amount of sunlight. Vitamin D is available not in the late afternoons or early mornings, it is somewhere between 10:30 to 1. This is the time when you can actually absorb the best amount of vitamin D. But just absorbing vitamin D or sitting in the sun or playing in the sun and then not having a healthy diet is not going to help. So we need to tell that they can still sit, take that dose of vitamin D where there is an open window or a gallery or somewhere out. So if they feel that they are unable to take that vitamin D dose of every day, please sit in the gallery, take fresh air and take that dose, you know, for that one half an hour, 45 minutes or whatever time it is. So, but yes, we still need vitamin D. And if that is also not possible, talk to your doctor. He or she can assess it. And if the levels are low, they can prescribe a medication, a supplement rather. It's not a medicine. A supplement can be taken and a healthy diet along with it, with milk and curd and all that can be taken. But vitamin D, not only in immunity, it helps. It is very, very important for all bodily functions.
Mike.
Ma'am is muted.
Ma'am, Mr. Shiv Behel and others, they wish to ask whether they can continue to eat non-vegetarian food during these times, or will this...
Yes, they can continue eating the non-vegetarian food, because once it is cooked, I'm sure there's all kinds of viruses and bacteria and everything can definitely be destroyed. But remember, from where they are getting that food is going to have a lot of handling also. So once you get it at home also, see to it that it is thoroughly washed in the right manner. And please, I'm sure there would be more questions coming in for how to wash vegetables and how to wash fruits and all that.
That
please
was the next question.
Yes, please go to the FSSAI site or go to the MOHW site. You have enough information government has loaded up, you know, kind of. So instead of taking resort to the WhatsApp University, please go on authentic sites and take information from there. There is enough amount of information which is put up on SSFAI site, and they have these all details of washing the hand, washing your vegetables, how to do a good shopping, grocery shopping, etc., etc. But take it from the authentic site. So we come back to this non-veg food. If your handling is done properly, if you have done good handling, you can thoroughly wash it, thoroughly cook it and eat it at the same time. And that is... So there is no restriction on taking any kind of a non-vegetarian food, just not to take it raw, which we anyways don't take it.
Dr. Kajal, there is yet another question. What is the diet plan of COVID-19 patient? Is it the same, or it should be something else should be added?
If you really tell me, it has to be the same. And I'm sure you were not... Same means if you were following
like
a healthy habit,
normal
Indian healthy meal, if you were following a well-balanced, you need to continue. But if you were not taking your regular meals, you were not including proteins, you were not including fruits and vegetables, not hydrating yourself, then it is going to be a different, then it is going to be a different menu plan. There's going to be a different menu plan, right? But if you were already taking a healthy meal, you are going to continue the same one. And be more cautious and be more sure that you eat everything.
Yes. And what about teenagers? Because they are not going outside these days. sitting at home. So what kind of diet do you yes. mothers are asking, doctor ma'am bolenge to bacche shayad khane lag jayenge.
No, that's why tell the kids that this is a new norm. They have had enough of eating from outside. They better taste mom's hand food, you know, kind of. And I would appreciate also those moms who are at home, working from home. It could be a double tasking, I understand. But if they are cooking the food and feeding their children and the family, I think nothing like that. Those mothers who are still working, I understand they can't cook. But those who are at home, and if they can make nice, delicious recipes, and children will definitely appreciate it.
Tasking, it is triple tasking.
I can understand. It could be a triple also. Yeah.
Like
you are all the time available, actually.
Myself, everything is happening.
I know. I can understand. But my message to them is that they need to still realize that if you need to gather immunity, if you need to have a body which has to functioning in the right manner, they need to eat food which is more healthier. So maybe for our generation, realization comes in a little late, but for the younger generation, the realization should come now.
Okay, I think we can go to the next one. Hanji. Next panelist.
Thank you so much, Dr. Kajal. We will come back to you again with questions that
there are a lot of questions pouring, and we have so much to cover up.
We'll
move to Dr. Bipin. Thank you so much. Dr. Bipin is the Ayurvedacharya for us from Medanta. And how does Ayurveda help us in boosting the immunity? There's so much of talk about and Ayush and Ayurveda. So what's the role of Ayurveda, Dr. Bipin? Please tell us.
Yes. So first of all, I want to start this talk with enhanced emphasis upon point that the first primary method of preventing this COVID-19 infections are mainly four things. One is the breaking chain, prevention, spreading of the disease. Second one is immunity enhancement. Third one, as Dr. Vikas said, early detection and medical care. This is our first four main points what you have to keep in mind. Now, coming to our role of Ayurveda in this scenario. See, Ayurveda is not simply giving some herbal medicines in the name of herbal thing. It's not like that. It's a way of living with some principles. Okay, it includes daily regimen, social contacts, seasonal regimen, and all these things. It's a way of living mainly, not a simple giving of medicines, herbal medicines. So, coming to the topic of immunity, what we are aiming here, as Dr. Vikas and Dr. Kajal said, with some medicines or some food, we cannot get that immunity in. But our aim is to make our body healthy, strong, to resist the disease, to prevent the infection. And once we are got infected, then it should not go to the severe stages. That's our intention. So regarding immunity. So for that, first of all, we ourselves should do a personal health insight. We should have a health insight. What's our condition, physical condition, in an allopathic way and Ayurveda way. Allopathic way means blood panels, lab reports, sugar levels, BP, like that. In Ayurveda, we used to consider some vital parameters that should be checked so that it will give a health insight of the person, like our appetite, sleep patterns, bowel bladder functioning, and mental well-being. These are four main important things what we have to assess.
Dr. Bipin, I would like to interrupt here. We have a lot of questions pouring in for you. I will just read out few because it might get late. What is the role of kadha in COVID-19 by Rashmi Sharma is the question.
Kadha questions are too many. Some people are asking, can I have haldi milk daily? Can I have, or what quantity should I, is so, okay for me?
So little of kadha, you can explain what is the importance of kadha for healthy and hypertensive and diabetic separately.
Okay, so I will come to that point. So first of all, the person should have a health insight, and we have four modalities of treatment or increasing immunity. First one is ahara or food. Second one is vihara or lifestyle activities. Third one is aushudha, that is medicine part. And fourth one, treatments. So you are asking about the khadas or medicine part. So which can be given as a home remedies. So mainly, according to Ayurveda perspective, all the diseases are mainly due to apnimandya, due to decreased internal metabolism. To increase our metabolism, we are giving this kadas and all, decoction all these medicines. So mainly they are carminative property. That means that will increase the digestion, that will increase the metabolism. For example, we can give a combination of tulsi, dalchini, adrak, black pepper. This is common thing what we are giving to our patients. Government of India also is suggesting the same combinations. Different combinations can be prepared depending upon the conditions. But we have to take care because this is a not common thing. Personalized approach should be done because if some patients have some persons have a tendency of increased bleeding, having an increased burning sensation in body like that, pitta puradi what we call. So such patients should not take this for a long time. In such conditions, we have to make modification. That depends upon the yukti of a vaidya or doctor.
Okay, so what I take from you, Dr. Bipin, is that we have to be aware of our pitta pravritti. कि हमारा बॉडी का किस तरह से वेदर वी आर
ऑफ कंपोजिशन ऑफ
द व्हाट काइंड ऑफ कंपोजिशन डू आई हैव अकॉर्डिंगली जैसे तासीर बोलते हैं हम खाने की तरह से तो उसमें अदरक तुलसी है और क्या नाम है हल्दी है ये सब हमारा मेरे ख्याल से गर्म है इनका तासीर तो जिनको हाइपरटेंशन है वो ना ले इसको ज्यादा कैसे Because इस पे बहुत questions आ रहे हैं लोग there are so many people because there was so much of talk on the TVs that you should have warm kada daily to avoid so we have questions from Dr. Dhingra who's asking that I am can I have adrak and haldi kada daily and how many times so क्या बताएं उनको what do I say
see So khada already I told you that's to increase metabolism, but it should not be taken for a long time.
Okay.
It will have some side effects also in body. So depending upon the necessity of the body, we have to take one thing. So instead of this khada, while preparing water, warm water, hot water in home, we can add such things like water can be prepared by adding adrak and coriander. Dhaniya, or by adding jeera, this all will help to increase the metabolism and our acne in the body. So such preparations can be taken, but depending upon the condition. But after taking this khada and all this for some period, they have some side effects. They have to change or stop that.
Stop it.
Great. So I'll say to the viewers, Dr. Bipin says that just don't. Go by that everyone is having kada so I should also have kada thrice a day of every day so Dr. Bipin says you that you have to see to it what is the pravritti of your the pitta pravritti of your body and accordingly वैसे भी daily वो चीज नहीं लेनी if you are taking it for 2 days after 2 days you should change and dhaniya jeera which are a whole pravritti you should add that and you yourself would know of your vat pravritti etc and accordingly you have to see and do not just go by what you are listening here or there and jo jisne bola wohi ki ayurveda is people feel ayurveda mein to kuch nahi hota na we are just taking some we are not taking any medicine from outside it is just some herbs so it won't affect but dr bipin is saying it does affect and we have to be really very careful so either we take care ask a doctor who can tell us what is the pravritti of my body and then I should take that kada otherwise I have to go slow And then, in that case, can Dr. Bipin, we can have just warm water and inhalations, etc., which will be better. What do you say?
Warm water, anyway, it's advisable. It's good to take warm water during this period. You can while preparing the warm water, you can add adrak and dhaniya. These are common practice what we are doing.
Okay.
You can prepare. There's no issue. But if it's creating some issues, we have to take like that.
And Dr. But like giloy and amla juice etc these are also as you just said that they also are immunity boosters so what company I know you will not say a particular company but at least kahan se liya jaye giloy agar ya fir How do I go about
I will
like
come to that.
Tablets are taken, our juices are better or tablets are better?
I will come to that point. See, there are two types of medicines in Ayurveda, with single drug medicines and formulations. So this Giloy, if you are taking as a single drug, it's better to take SH. Like here in Medanta, we have a herbal garden. We are giving patients freshly prepared juice of Giloy. We have to crush it and make juice out of that, and we can give. Because if you are buying some Giloy, only prepared Giloy juice from outside, it will not be that much beneficial for the people. So if you are, if you want to take, make it freshly and take like that.
Okay. And the last one that I ask from you is that people are saying whether kadha and milk, can we have them together, or can, should we have put all this turmeric etc. in water, that, if that is more better, or having it in milk is better? That's another.
So I know that here in particularly North India, that practice is there, combination of haldi and milk, that's called golden milk. People used to take that. It's considered to be good preventing infections and all these things. But while taking this also, we have to consider something. If there is an underlying aknimandya or decreased metabolism, it should not be taken. I know people used to take this milk before, just before going to bed in the night.
Yes,
immediately before going to bed, they used to take. According to my opinion, it's not a good practice if the underlying metabolism is not good. So it's better to take along with breakfast or during daytime. So that during daytime, this combination is good. But particularly in the night before going to bed, if they have underlying issues, some issues like aknimandya and all these things, it's not. It's better to avoid that in night. Curd also.
Curd should be avoided at night.
Night.
Okay. Okay. Dr. Bipin, there is another question which says, what is the right time to have warm water?
Right time.
What is the right time to have warm water, before meals or after meals?
This also I want to emphasize, because there are different practices of taking warm water also. I have a lot of patients, those who came to me, they have a practice of taking more than 4 to 5 glasses of water in empty stomach early morning for proper bowel movements. Those who are taking like that, they have, I have seen lot of patients with severe digestive issues. So my advice is that you can take up to 1 or 2 plus maximum in empty stomach, not more than that.
Okay.
And so I think this is very, very important for audience to understand. This is a normal practice among people, which I see that people have this habit of taking lot of water in the early morning. So I think we can avoid this practice and have just 2 glasses of water in the morning.
Honey and lemon, that is fine. Huh? Warm water with honey and lemon. That's
another controversy I want to tell. Actually, a lot of ads and all these are coming on TVs regarding this concept, taking honey, lemon and hot water in the morning. But personally, my opinion is it should be personalized. It's not good for everybody, because this also depends upon the prakriti. In Ayurveda classic textbook is mentioned, if we are taking honey with hot water, it will act like a toxin. It will act like toxin. So it's clearly mentioned in the classic Ayurveda textbooks. So I am not supporting that. And this combination of honey and water is mentioned in the context of obesity, in treating obesity in Ayurveda. So means that this is a concept of like preparing, making a toxin in the body, and by formation of this toxin, this obesity is treated. So for a long term, according to my opinion, this honey combination of honey, lemon and hot water in the morning, it's not advisable. I know it's a controversy, but this is depending upon the class textbooks, this is our advice.
We can say for 1 week and then stop again 1 week, give a gap of a week or kind of a thing, or kind of, so that, is it fine?
You can do like that, but long term career, don't take this combination. This is my advice, and this is a controversy. But
okay.
Simple warm water to be taken before meals or after meals for digestion.
Simple in small quantity you can take before meals. There is no problem, but it's better to take after meal.
after meals. So warm water to be taken after meals.
In Ayurveda, there is another concept also regarding the intake of water and solid foods. So we used to tell the patient, like, consider your stomach capacity as three parts. One should be filled with solid food items, one should be filled with liquids, and one should be kept empty. Means people should not take excess operating should be prevented. For that, we used to sell this concept to the patients.
Thank you so much, Dr. Bipin.
Thank you, very
much. Questions are too many and the time is too less. And now we come to you, Mr. Deepak. Thank you so much. With Ayurveda, we also have yoga, the way of living. So, coming to you, Dr. Deepak.
Yes. Yes, Charuji, बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद आपको. और इतने लोग आपके फेसबुक से जुड़े हैं, उन सभी को सबसे पहले मेरा नमस्कार. और आपके स्कूल के सारे पेरेंट्स को भी मेरा नमस्कार. देखिए, इतनी देर से इतनी नॉलेज की बात सुन रहे थे सारे लोग, तो मैं सोच के हैरान हूँ कि कुछ योगा करा दिया जाए अभी तो. सबसे क्योंकि सब लोग बैठे हुए हैं, थक गए हैं, मोबाइल हाथ में लिए हुए हैं, तो मैं सबसे रिक्वेस्ट करूंगा और सबसे हाथ जोड़ के प्रार्थना करूंगा कि जो जहां पे है अपने मोबाइल वहीं पे रख दीजिए. 10 सेकंड के लिए खड़े होके ताड़ासन में स्ट्रेच करिए बॉडी को पूरा का पूरा, तो आप सारे लोग थोड़ी सी एनर्जेटिक हो जाएंगे. जस्ट खड़े होके बैक को स्ट्रेच करेंगे.
ओके.
तो इससे क्या है कि आप लोग चेयर पे बैठे हैं, सोफे पे हैं, कैसे भी हैं, तो मतलब बैक का जो पोस्चर है वो गड़बड़ हो गया था. सो नाउ विल स्टार्ट. तो सबसे पहले हम बात करेंगे कि आज हमें योगा क्यों करना चाहिए. योगा तो बहुत सारी चीजें योगा में करने के लिए, हमें क्यों करना चाहिए, आपको क्यों करना चाहिए, और योगा में ऐसी कौन सी चीजें हैं कि हम करें तो फायदा होगा. हमने काढ़ा के बारे में सुना, हमने डाइट के बारे में सुना, हमने डॉक्टर से बचाव के बारे में सुना कि क्या करना चाहिए. मैं आप लोगों से एक संकल्प लेना चाहता हूं. आप लोग खुद से संकल्प लें कि आज से मैं 20 मिनट्स एवरी डे आई विल डू योगा. अगर आप योगा करेंगे तो आप सारी महामारी से, कोरोना से बचेंगे. पॉजिटिविटी सिर्फ बोलने से नहीं आएगी कि मैंने बोल दिया, चारू जी ने बोल दिया, बच्चों को डांट दिया और सारे पॉजिटिव हो जाएंगे, ऐसे नहीं आने वाली है. आपको अपने से फाइट करना पड़ेगा, अपने से संकल्प लेना पड़ेगा. मन कहता है सो जाओ, मन कहता है खाना खा लो, तो ये नहीं सुनना है. हमें क्या करना है कि 20 मिनट योगा करना है. तो 20 मिनट में क्या क्या करना है वो मैं आपको पहले बता देता हूँ. बहुत बेसिक चीज, चाहे आप डायबिटीज के पेशेंट हैं, चाहे आप ब्लड प्रेशर के पेशेंट हैं, चाहे आप हार्ट के पेशेंट हैं, मैं 20 मिनट का जो प्रोग्राम बताने जा रहा हूँ वो सिर्फ पॉजिटिविटी लाने के लिए, कि आपके अंदर एक नई ऊर्जा का संचार कर सके, आप एक नए इंसान बन सके. जो बीमारियां हो तो ठीक हो जाएंगी, लेकिन हम अपने से पहले जीत लें. तो दो आसन आपको खड़े होके करना है. एक तो ताड़ासन करना है, दूसरा आसन है आपको वृक्षासन, ट्री पोज करना है खड़े होके. बैठ के दो आसन करना है, पश्चिमोत्तानासन करना है और अर्धमत्स्येन्द्रासन करना है. इन दोनों का भी मैं फायदा भी बताता जाऊं. फिर आपको पीठ के बल पर लेट के करना है, हलासन करना है और नौकासन करना है. पेट के बल पर लेट के भुजंगासन करना है और आपको सलावासन करना है. तो दो दो आसन आपको कॉम्बिनेशन हो गया, पैकेज हो गया. अब अगर आप सारे के सारे लोग रोज करेंगे तो बिल्कुल स्वस्थ रहेंगे. वो आपको चारों से कोई ये नहीं बोलने आएगा कि मेरा बच्चा मुझे परेशान करता है, मुझे गुस्सा आता है. फिर बच्चा भी परेशान करता रहेगा, मम्मी पापा आपस में लड़ते भी रहेंगे, लेकिन सबका मन शांत रहेगा. पॉजिटिविटी की जो हम बात कर रहे हैं, तो इट स्टार्ट विद इन. होता क्या है, हम जिम्मेदारी नहीं लेते हैं. हम जब जिम्मेदारी अगर लेना सीख जाते हैं या शुरू कर देते हैं तो हम दूसरे को ब्लेम करना बंद कर देते हैं. तो योगा से क्या होता है, यू स्टार्ट टेकिंग रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी. आपके पास हमारे साथ कोई स्कूल का बच्चा है, वो हमारे साथ जुड़ जाए और वो एक चारों आसन करके दिखाएं, चारों मतलब स्टैंडिंग, सिटिंग, लाइन.
वी हैव वंशा, हु इज अ स्टूडेंट ऑफ आवर स्कूल. वी विल टेक हिम. वंशज, प्लीज put your video on. Yes, Vanshaj is there.
So Vanshaj, अगर show करके दिखा देंगे तो इनके सारे देखने वालों को समझ में आ जाएगा मैंने कितने आसान सी चीजें बताई हैं।
दीपक सर आप बोले या वंशज करें?
आप हाँ,
हाँ,
आप बोल।
वंशज सबसे पहले बेटा आपको करना है ताड़ासन। खड़े हो जाएंगे सीधा, दोनों फीट अपार्ट और दोनों हाथ को स्ट्रेच करेंगे ऊपर ले जाके, इंटरलॉक करके फिंगर्स को, जस्ट स्ट्रेच नाइसली, जितना आप आराम से स्ट्रेच करते ना। सपोज आपको स्ट्रेच करने में बिल्कुल
वंशज पिन कर दें हम ताकि सबको वंशज दिखे।
हाँ इस तरीके से आपको एवरीडे 5 times रिपीट करना है। सपोज आप घर पे बैठे हैं, किसी से झगड़ा हो गया, किसी ने आपको कुछ बोल दिया, कुछ भी है, खड़े होके अपने आपको पनिशमेंट करना है। जब हम अपने आपको पनिशमेंट करते हैं तो समझ जाना कि आप सक्सेस के रास्ते पे चलने वाले हैं। वापिस आ जाओ वंशज, वेरी गुड। इसके बाद आपको करना है वृक्षासन, त्रिपोज। वेरी नाइस। तो बच्चे ने बहुत आसानी से कर लिया है। इसमें सारे बहुत सारे लोग ऐसे आएंगे बोलेंगे सर हमसे नहीं होता है। नहीं होता है इसीलिए करना है, जिस दिन आपसे होने लगेगा तो आपको नहीं बोलेंगे कि करना है। तो जिनको जिनको नहीं होता है, डिफिकल्टीज होती है इसको करने में, वो सारे लोग ट्राई करें। बहुत सिंपल है ये, आपके नर्वस सिस्टम को रिलैक्स करता है, बॉडी का जो अलाइनमेंट है, जैसे आप लोग कार ड्राइव करते हैं तो उसके अगर अलाइनमेंट बिगड़ जाए तो गाड़ी लेफ्ट राइट कहीं भी जाएगी, आपके हाथ में स्टीयरिंग रहेगा बट कंट्रोल नहीं रहेगा। इसी तरीके से हमारे बॉडी को अलाइनमेंट करने के लिए ताड़ासन और वृक्षासन बहुत जरूरी है। वापस आ जाओ वंशज।
इसके बाद एक क्वेश्चन है आपके लिए, आसन फॉर बैक एक भी चाहिए बाय भूमि सूदी।
डेफिनेटली भूमि जी को बोलिए कि बेफिक्र रहे, अलाइनमेंट में सबसे पहला काम करें कि ताड़ासन और वृक्षासन करना शुरू कर दे, तो बैक को स्ट्रेच करना है। उनको बोल दीजिए कि दोनों आसन करें। इसके बाद जो मैं आसन बताने जा रहा हूँ वो भूमि जी करें। अर्ध मत्स्येंद्र आसन करना है आपको, अर्ध मत्स्येंद्र आसना। वंशज अर्ध मत्स्येंद्र आसन, पैर मोड़ के ऐसे, यस वेरी गुड। तो भूमि जी आप इसको भी कर सकती हैं, आपका बैक पेन के लिए भी अच्छा है, जिनको डायबिटीज है डायबिटीज वाले लोग भी कर सकते हैं इसको, इसका फायदा उठा सकते हैं।
डॉक्टर मुश्किल नहीं होगा, मतलब ये तो
बिल्कुल मुश्किल नहीं है, बच्चे की फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी बहुत ज्यादा है, बच्चे ने बहुत एक्स्ट्रा एडवांस पोस्चर किया हुआ है, तो हमें इसके लिए खुश होना चाहिए और हमें इस बच्चे से मोटिवेट होकर इसकी तरह बनने का प्रयास करना चाहिए।
आप आसान आसान चीजें बताइए।
बताने वाला दूसरा है पश्चिमोत्तानासन, इसको बैक पेन वाले ना करें, बाकी सारे लोग कर सकते हैं। ओबेसिटी, जिनका पेट निकला है, जिनको स्किन में ग्लो चाहिए, चेहरे पे चमक चाहिए, वो लोग जरूर करें इस आसन को। दोनों हाथ ऊपर उठाओगे वंशज और सामने झुकोगे।
दीपक जी हम ना COVID-19 से लड़ने के लिए जो जो चाहिए और थोड़े आसान वाले,
बिल्कुल है, जो है
आपको लंग के मुश्किल चीजें देख के लोग कुछ करें ही ना, ऐसा ना हो, तो वो आप करा दीजिए थोड़ा हमें।
ठीक है, इसके बाद वंशज आप लेट जाएंगे, जमीन पर लेट जाइए, पीठ के बल पे, पीठ के बल पे लेट जाइए और कोशिश पीठ ऑन योर बैक। तो सबसे पहले इस तरह लेट गए, दोनों पैर ऊपर ले जाएंगे 90 डिग्री पे लेग्स। अब इसमें जो बहुत ज्यादा मोटे लोग हैं या नहीं कर पाते हैं वो एक पैर ऊपर ले जा सकते हैं। बच्चे ने दोनों पैर बड़े आसानी से ले गया, इसको करेंगे कम से कम 5 बार और 10 सेकेंड, 15 सेकेंड, 20 सेकेंड के लिए रोक देंगे। वंशज इसके बाद साइकिलिंग करना, जैसे पैर से साइकिल चलाते हैं तो साइकिल कम से कम 4 से 5 मिनट करें। अगर कुछ भी नहीं करते हैं आप साइकिलिंग करिए, आपका डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम ठीक रहेगा, खाने का सिस्टम सही हो जाएगा, अपने आप इम्यून सिस्टम बढ़ेगा और मेटाबॉलिक रेट को बढ़ाने के लिए साइकिलिंग बहुत अच्छी चीज है। इसके बाद वापस आ जाएंगे, पेट के बल पे लेट जाएंगे। सबसे पहले हम भुजंगासन करेंगे, कोबरा पोज। अब एक बहुत ज्यादा फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी है, सिंपल तरीके से करो वंशज, इतना करने का नहीं करने का, नहीं तो लोग डर के भाग जाएंगे, बोलेंगे हमें योगा वोगा नहीं करना, हमें उनको भगाना नहीं है, डराना नहीं है। ऊपर देखो आप छत के ऊपर, यस। तो इतना ही करना है, बाकी लोगों को इतना ही करना है, किसी का इससे भी कम है इससे भी कम कीजिए, बट करना जरूर है।
मैंने कहीं सुना था कि जो स्ट्रेस है दैट इज इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू इम्यूनिटी, तो किसी चीज को बहुत ज्यादा स्ट्रेस लेके करेंगे तो भी इम्यूनिटी हमारी घटती है, तो हमें मुस्कुराते हुए जितना हो जाए स्ट्रेच करना है और स्माइल को भी स्ट्रेच करना है,
ताकि बिल्कुल स्थिरम सुखम आसनम। चारू जी आपने बहुत अच्छी बात बोली, मुस्कुराते हुए स्टेबिलिटी होना चाहिए आपके आसन में और प्रसन्नता हैप्पीनेस आपके चेहरे पे वो ग्लो आना चाहिए। वापस आ जाओ वंस नीचे और दोनों हाथ आगे ले जाएं।
भुजंगासन बैक के लिए बहुत
अच्छा, यस बैक के लिए काफी अच्छा है, आपका चेस्ट लंग कैपेसिटी को एक्सपेंड करता है तो लंग के लिए अच्छा है, शॉर्ट के लिए जिनको अस्थम सॉरी आपका थायराइड का प्रॉब्लम है उनके लिए भी काफी अच्छा है। इसके बाद आप वंस दोनों हाथों को थाइज के नीचे रख के शलभासन करेंगे जो कि बैक के लिए भी अच्छा है। यस इसमें पहले एक एक पैर ऊपर उठाएंगे फिर दोनों पैर एक साथ ऊपर उठाएंगे, तो डिपेंड करता है अगर आप बहुत मोटे हैं बहुत हेल्दी हैं तो दोनों पैर नहीं उठाइएगा, एक पैर ऊपर उठाइए फिर दूसरा पैर ऊपर उठाइए ऑल्टरनेट करके, तो पांच पांच बार करके ओके रिलैक्स करो वंस।
कुछ प्राणायाम जो हर कोई कर सकता हो, कोरोना के हम बात कर रहे हैं कि भाई ब्रीदिंग प्रॉब्लम होती है कुछ, तो हम अपनी लंग कैपेसिटी को जिससे बढ़ा सके मिस्टर दीपक, तो वो बताइए कुछ ऐसे वाले प्राणायाम जो कि हाइपरटेंसिव या डायबिटिक भी कर सकते हो और जिससे हमारी लंग कैपेसिटी बढ़े, ऐसा कुछ आप हमें बताइए।
मैं आज आपको दो तरह का प्राणायाम बताने जा रहा हूँ, जो आपने ऑक्सीमीटर लेके शुरू में बताया था हमारे दर्शकों को, तो अगर आप देखेंगे ऑक्सीमीटर अगर 5 से 7 मिनट आप प्राणायाम कर लेंगे जो इस तरीके से मैं बताया तो आपका जो ऑक्सीजन लेवल है 97-98 से नीचे ही नहीं आएगा, और जब ऑक्सीजन लेवल 97-96 पे ऊपर रहता है तो इसका मतलब है कि आपकी बॉडी की जितनी ऑक्सीजन की रिक्वायरमेंट है वो आप फुलफिल कर रहे हैं। तो सबसे पहले क्या करना है, आपको सहज तरीके से सभी लोगों को अनुलोम विलोम प्राणायाम करना है। अनुलोम विलोम में रेशियो क्या रहेगा कि 5 सेकेंड आपने श्वास खींचा, घड़ी देखते हुए आप 5 सेकेंड तक श्वास खींचिए और 10 सेकेंड श्वास रोकना है आपको, 10 सेकेंड श्वास रोकिए। फिर दाहिने तरफ से राइट नॉस्ट्रिल से 5 सेकेंड में श्वास छोड़िए,
लेफ्ट टू राइट, लेफ्ट से शुरू
करना है, यस लेफ्ट से 5 सेकेंड श्वास लिया, 10 सेकेंड श्वास रोकना है, फिर 5 सेकेंड में राइट से ब्रीद आउट किया, फिर 5 सेकेंड राइट से ब्रीद इन, 10 सेकेंड होल्ड, 5 सेकेंड में ब्रीद आउट, सो 5-10-5 इस रेशियो से हमें करना है। इसके बाद इससे होगा क्या कि आपका लंग कैपेसिटी बढ़ जाएगा, बॉडी का ऑक्सीजन लेवल बढ़ जाएगा, और जो लोग कहते हैं मेरा बेटा मेरे बस में नहीं है, मेरी पत्नी बस में नहीं है, मेरा पति मेरे बस में नहीं है, अरे भाई दुनिया को आप बस में करना चाहते हो, हमारा मन हमारे बस में नहीं है ये कोई नहीं कहता है, तो सबसे पहला काम ये करना कि हमको अपने मन को बस में करना है, तो इस प्राणायाम से आप अपने बस में होना सीख जाएंगे, फिर सारी दुनिया आपके बस में हो जाएगी। तो सबसे पहला सबक ये है। दूसरा प्राणायाम है चंद्रवेदी प्राणायाम, जो कि आपने पूछा बीपी ब्लड प्रेशर के लिए, चिड़चिड़ापन गुस्सा आना बहुत ज्यादा निगेटिविटी ढूंढना हर एक चीज में, अगर हम चंद्रवेदी प्राणायाम करेंगे तो चंद्रमा की तरह हमारा मन बिल्कुल शांत रहेगा। आप चांदनी रात में
दीपक जी एक मिनट आपको इंटरवीन कर रही हूँ, हियर आई थिंक डॉक्टर विकास देसवाल वॉन्ट्स टू लीव, ही हैज टू अटेंड अनदर सेशन आफ्टर दिस, so we thank Dr. Vikas Deswal for joining and it was such an informative session Dr. Vikas, it's been amazing to have you in this session, thank you Vikas, Dr. Vikas,
thank you Dr. Meenakshi,
thank you so much for joining, thank you so much
for giving me this opportunity, thank you, I'm sorry I have to leave because I have another webinar at 7 p.m. I'm sorry for that,
thank you it was great having you in the session,
thank you ma'am.
हाँ जी मैम प्लीज कंटिन्यू।
सो मैं बता रहा था कि प्राणायाम, तो दूसरा प्राणायाम है चंद्रवेदी प्राणायाम, उसको आपको करना है सिंपल तरीके से 3-4 मिनट कर लीजिए, सुबह दोपहर शाम कभी भी कर लीजिए, ऑफिस में है, घर में है, स्कूल में है, कहीं भी बैठ के कर लीजिए। कार स्टार्ट करने से पहले कार में बैठ के 5 मिनट कर लीजिए। जिंदगी का सबसे बेहतरीन तरीका है, अगर आप 5-7 मिनट अपने लिए निकालना शुरू कर देंगे, यकीन मानिए दुनिया में सबसे बड़ा चमत्कार यही होगा कि आप हमेशा खुश रहना सीख जाएंगे, आप हमेशा अपनी एनर्जी को समझ पाएंगे। आप किसी डॉक्टर के पास जाते ही, मैं एक सिंपल सा एग्जांपल देता हूँ मीनाक्षी जी, यहाँ पे बहुत सारे लोग हैं डॉक्टर के पास जाते हैं और कहते हैं डॉक्टर साहब मुझे बीमारी हो गई है। डॉक्टर रिपोर्ट देखते हैं कहते हैं आपको इतनी नहीं, 2 बीमारियां और हैं। वो वहां पे स्ट्रेस में आ जाते हैं, डिप्रेशन में चले जाते हैं कि यार पता नहीं अब मेरा क्या होगा, मेरा कुछ नहीं हो सकता। तो उस कंडीशन में आपकी जो हैप्पीनेस, खुश रहने की आदत है, वो आपको बचा लेती है। तो दूसरा तरीका होता है कि आप डॉक्टर के पास जाते हैं, डॉक्टर कहते हैं आपके पास 10 बीमारियां हैं। तो मरीज कहता है डॉक्टर साहब कोई बात नहीं, मैं सब सही कर लूंगा, अपना खाना पीना सही करूंगा, एक्सरसाइज सही करूंगा, मेडिसिन ऑन टाइम, सो आई विल बी ऑल राइट विद इन अ फ्यू मंथ्स। तो एटीट्यूड, तो योगा क्या करता है, आपका एटीट्यूड चेंज करता है, आपका मैंने जो बताया कि ऊर्जा लेवल बदल देता है। तो चंद्रभेदी प्राणायाम, अपना राइट हैंड से राइट नोस्ट्रिल को बंद करेंगे, लेफ्ट नोस्ट्रिल से श्वास खींचना है, लगभग 7-8 सेकंड श्वास खींचिए, ब्रीद इन एंड नाउ ब्रीद आउट फ्रॉम सेम नोस्ट्रिल, लेफ्ट नोस्ट्रिल से श्वास बाहर फॉर 8 सेकंड, ब्रीद आउट ब्रीद आउट ब्रीद आउट, अगेन ब्रीद इन फ्रॉम द लेफ्ट, ब्रीद आउट फ्रॉम द लेफ्ट, ब्रीद इन ब्रीद आउट,
ब्रीद इन और ब्रीद आउट सेम टाइम के लिए होना चाहिए, दोनों 8-8 सेकंड के लिए।
हाँ, इसमें 8-8 सेकंड के लिए होगा, क्योंकि हमें इसमें रोकना नहीं है श्वास, ब्लड प्रेशर के लिए है, हार्ट डिजीज के लिए है, जिनको कोलेस्ट्रॉल वगैरह बढ़ गया उनके लिए भी है,
ब्लड प्रेशर,
तो जो लोग तो जो लोग बहुत डिप्रेशन में भी आ जाते हैं उनके लिए भी काफी अच्छा है। तो हमने पहला जो प्राणायाम बताया वो फिजिकल फिटनेस को सही करेगा, दूसरा प्राणायाम जो बताया वो मेंटल हेल्थ को इशू को रिजोल्व करेगा, और जो हमने एक्सरसाइज 8 आसन बताए हैं उस वो आपके बॉडी में बैक पेन, शोल्डर पेन, नेक पेन, लेग पेन को सही करेगा, प्लस आपका लाइफ में एटीट्यूड बदल जाएगा जिंदगी के लिए।
दीपक जी, आपके लिए एक क्वेश्चन आया है, करेक्ट टाइम योगा करने का कौन सा होता है, योगा करने का सही टाइम कौन सा है, व्हाट इज द करेक्ट टाइम ऑफ डूइंग योगा?
देखिए, करेक्ट टाइम कोई नहीं बचा है आज के टाइम पे, बिकॉज मैं मॉडर्न लाइफस्टाइल को देखते हुए बात करूंगा, मैं बोलूंगा 4 बजे उठ के आसन करिए, 5 बजे करिए, नहीं पॉसिबल। अगर आप रात के 11 बजे सो जाते हैं तो सुबह 6 बजे उठ के आप योगा कर लीजिए, अगर आप रात के 2 बजे उठ सोते हैं और सुबह 8 बजे उठते हैं तो आप सुबह उठ के अपना योगा कीजिए। कहने का मेरा मतलब है आप जब भी उठते हैं सुबह, उसके बाद फ्रेश होने के बाद अपना योगा कीजिए। अगर आपको सुबह टाइम नहीं है तो खाने से 3 घंटे बाद कभी भी आप योगा कर सकते हैं। अगर आपने 1 बजे लंच किया है तो आप 4 बजे योगा कीजिए, 2 बजे लंच किया है तो 5 बजे कर लीजिए। इस तरीके से जब भी टाइम मिलता है आपको तब भी कीजिए, मेरा ये मानना है।
एक और क्वेश्चन आया आपके लिए, योगा के कितनी देर के बाद खाना खाना चाहिए?
आधे घंटे बाद खाना खा सकते हैं।
तो योगा के तुरंत बाद खाना नहीं खाना चाहिए,
20 मिनट से आधा घंटा तक का गैप कर लें, जिससे बॉडी कूल डाउन हो जाए, सिम्टम्स रिलैक्स हो जाए, स्टमक का।
डॉक्टर काजल या कोई बता सकेगा, बिकॉज डॉक्टर विकास तो अब चले गए हैं, बिकॉज ही हैव टू जॉइन अनदर मीटिंग, बिकॉज ये क्वेश्चन बहुत लोगों ने पूछा है कि व्हाट इज द कॉस्ट ऑफ द कोविड टेस्ट एट मेदांता?
I will not be able to say that. They'll have to call up the hospital and they will answer for that.
Fine. Dr. Kajal, since you are here, there is another question waiting for you. Can children have ice creams and cold drinks during this season?
They can have, no issues. But it is just maybe in a smaller portion, not too much, kind of. Right, but anyways, they were having before COVID also, and they are going to have now also when COVID is there. But remember, ice cream is still is a healthier food than carbonated drinks. So avoid carbonated drinks. If given a choice, a juice is fine. So if I have to rate it, then I can say ice cream can be taken, then juices can be taken, and carbonated only if nothing is available and really, really throws tantrums, then only give. Otherwise, might as well make a nice nimbupani at home.
So nimbu pani is the best. Simple nimbu pani is the trick.
Yes.
Acha.
डॉक्टर दीपक, मिस्टर दीपक आपसे पूछ रहे हैं लोग कि क्या आसन खाली खाली पेट पे ही करने चाहिए कि कुछ ऐसे भी आसन हैं जो हम कुछ खाना खा के भी कर सकते हैं।
देखिए ये तो हो गई बात वही कि हम कब ना करने का बहाना है लोगों का। मैं सिंपल सी बात बताऊं, कभी भी कर ले, कभी भी करे, क्योंकि जो मैंने आसन बताए वो आप खाने के 1.5-2 घंटे बाद भी कर सकते हैं। बहुत सिंपल आसन है कि अगर आपको बैक में दर्द हो रहा है तो आप एक योगा मैट डालिए, 2 मिनट अपना स्ट्रेच कर लिया, बैक आपका फिट एंड फाइन हो जाएगा। प्राणायाम जो मैंने बताया बहुत सरल तरीके से बताया, तो आप कभी भी कर लीजिए। लेकिन अगर आप प्रॉपर 1 घंटे का आसन करने जा रहे हैं, वर्कआउट करने जा रहे हैं, तो खाने से पहले कीजिए अथवा खाने के 3 घंटे बाद कीजिए। 3 घंटे लगते हैं खाने को डाइजेस्ट होने में, तो बेसिक पर्पज ये है कि खाना डाइजेस्ट हो जाए।
एक और हम कह रहे हैं योग निद्रा में चले जाए तो कैसा?
मैं इनको बोलता हूँ पहले सूर्य नमस्कार कर, ये जो लोग बोल रहे हैं योग निद्रा में जाए, अच्छी बात है, आप जाइए योग निद्रा कीजिए, लेकिन इनको बोलिए कि योग निद्रा करने से पहले सूर्य नमस्कार कर लें, थोड़ा अनुलोम विलोम कर लें, ज्यादा बेहतर रहेगा, इसके बाद योग निद्रा करें तो मजा आएगा इनको।
आपके लिए एक और सवाल पूछा जा रहा है कि ये छोटे बच्चों को मेडिटेशन करना चाहिए कि नहीं?
बिल्कुल करना चाहिए, सबके लिए करना चाहिए, छोटे बच्चे भी हैं बड़े बच्चे भी हैं। लेकिन मेडिटेशन क्या होता है कि अगर आप शरीर के साथ जाते हैं, कि स्टेप बाय स्टेप चलते हैं, तो आपका मेडिटेशन भी होगा और योगा भी होगा। तो आप योगा में सूर्य नमस्कार कीजिए, छोटे बच्चे हैं, 3-4 मिनट आप अनुलोम विलोम कीजिए, उसके बाद कोशिश करिए कि आंख बंद करके 5-7 मिनट बैठने का प्रयास कीजिए। बच्चों के लिए बेसिक मेडिटेशन यही है, या कोई एक काला पॉइंट सफेद बिंदु बना लें, त्राटक जिसको बोलते हैं, क्योंकि बच्चे आंख बंद करके बैठना मुश्किल होता है। तो जैसे हम एक गेम खेलते थे बचपन में कि मेरी आंखों में देखो भाई कि कौन कितनी देर तक बगैर पलके झपकाए हुए अपनी आंखें खोल सकता है, तो छोटा सा काला बिंदु बना लीजिए अपना 1-1.5 फीट की दूरी पे आई लेवल पे, और उसको खोल के आंखें खोल के एकदम देखते रहना है सिंपल तरीके से। एक गेम में आपका मेडिटेशन भी हो जाएगा, आपकी याददाश्त भी बढ़ जाएगी, आपके अंदर पॉजिटिविटी भी आ जाएगी, और आप देखेंगे बहुत अच्छे बच्चे बनके माँ बाप का नाम रोशन करेंगे, माँ बाप को परेशान नहीं करेंगे।
So we are coming to the end of the session.
Yes.
But the questions are continuing, they're just pouring in.
You can take those questions and email it to us. I can write the answers.
Oh, sure, get back to
you and you can provide it to them. You know, kind of.
That's really great. That's really nice of you, Dr. Kapil and Dr. Bipin and Mr. Deepak. Thank you so much for joining in, and thanks to all the parents, all the students, and everybody who has joined in. And my big thanks to Dr. Meenakshi, our in-house doctor. She's such a creative and person.
Thank you, ma'am.
Who has collected everyone in a jiffy and planned all of this for us.
This was a much needed session right now. We still have questions pouring. I don't know, still so many questions to go. But I'll have to stop it now.
Yeah, so we will.
Thank you so much.
This was just the first series of webinar, and it has seen a very overwhelming response. And so you don't, Dr. Kajal, we will take you again, so please come.
Surely, definitely. Similarly,
Dr. Bipin and Mr. Deepak, we will take you again.
Thank you so much.
Because there are so many questions for you guys, and parents are asking something. Yes, ma'am.
Please continue.
I just said thank you so much, everyone, and namaskar. Fir milenge.
Thank you. Stay safe.
Thank you. Stay safe. Stay healthy. Stay home.
Stay safe. Stay healthy. Till we meet physically. So let's keep.
Yes.
Very nice.
Digitally. Till we meet physically.
Okay. Take care.
Thank you. Take care.
Thank you. Bye.